हॅलो स्टुडंट, आय एम मीनाक्षी चंदनखेडे, असिस्टंट प्रोफेसर ॲट डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ कम्प्युटर सायन्स अँड इंजिनिअरिंग ॲट GH रायसोनी अकॅडमी ऑफ इंजिनिअरिंग अँड टेक्नॉलॉजी नागपूर. टुडे आय एम गोईंग टू कंडक्ट वन लेक्चर ऑन दी डेटा स्ट्रक्चर अँड अल्गोरिदम. नाव लेट स्टार्ट विथ दी इंट्रोडक्शन ऑफ दी डेटा स्ट्रक्चर. नाव वॉट इज दी definition of the data structure. Data structure gives a way to storing the information in a well organized manner in a computer's memory. Basically, data structure and algorithm are strongly correlated to each other. Well set of algorithms and the data structure makes the computer program more efficient. That is, algorithm plus data structure equals to gives an efficient program. Now let's start with the classification of the data structure. Classification of the data structure. Now the diagram for classification of data structure is, data structure is classified into two types, that is primitive data structure, primitive data structure, and second one is it classified into non-primitive data structure. Now primitive data structure are classified into the integer, float, character and pointers. Now non-primitive data structure are again divided into array. Second one is the list, and third one, that is your file. Now start with the classification. First of all, data structure, that is classified into two types, that is primitive data structure and non-primitive data structure. Primitive data structure, these are the basic data structure, that means that are built in system in any programming language. Examples are integer, float, character and pointer. Now non-primitive data structures are classified into array, list and files. First of all, we see the concept of array. What is meant by the array? The concept of array is what? Let us take an example. Suppose there are four elements, 10, 20, 30 and 40. Always array is identified with the help of the array name. Suppose the array name is, suppose num is the array here, and here indexes always start from the 0, 1, 2 and 3. Basically what is meant by the array? Array is array stores the similar type of data, where we can either say that array is a collection of homogeneous type of data. That means it holds similar type of data. Either the integers, float, otherwise the characters. Now, here the indexes also known as the subscripts or index. Okay, now array is of two type. Basically this is the one dimensional array, and another one is the two dimensional array also. Now what is the difference between one dimensional array and the two dimensional array? Here we can see here only the one dimension, that is only one substrate is here from 0 to up to 3, but in this there are two dimensions, 0 1 2 0 1 2. Here two dimensions are, first subscript is your row, and first subscript is your row, that is row 1, row 2 and row 3, starting from the index 0 1 2. Same for the column also, first column, second column and third column. That means value in particular two dimensional array is identified with the help of this, that is your 0 and 0. That means two dimensional array here, these are the two examples, or we can say the types of array, that is one dimensional array and second one is the two dimensional array. Now second concept of non-primitive data structure is the list. This is your first, and now second one, that is your list. Now list basically used for the variable type of data. The format of its is, here is the head and data. Suppose first data is 10. Now second, in second field there is a pointer of second node, that is 20, and here is the null. Now list comprises of two element, basically at least two element. In first field it stores the data, and in second field it stores the address of the next element. Here is no next element, that's why the in link field there is null. This is our second non-preemptive data structure. Now the third one, that is our file. Now what is meant by file and what is the use of file basically? Suppose we want to store the data permanently in a secondary storage, that is your hard disk, floppy disk, etc. In that condition there is a use of file. And when we want to store large amount of data and to process large amount of data, in that condition there is a use of file, and it is basically identified with the help of file name. That is, take an example, suppose abc.dat. Here this is your primary, here this is your primary file name and this is your secondary primary name, and primary and secondary, that is separated with the help of dot operator. This is three basic non-primitive data structures. Now here for this one, list is comprises, that is second, our second one that is extended here, that is list. Again we can divide it into two parts, that is linear and second one is the non-linear. Now linear data, linear list and non-linear list. Here linear list first, that is linear list are represented with the help of stack, and second one is the queue. Same, second, that is non-linear list is comprises of two, that is tree, and second one is the graph. Now, first of all, we see the concept of stack. What is meant by the concept of stack? Basically, the concept of stack is last in, first out. That means the number that comes in stack, that comes out first. Take an example for stack. Suppose this is your stack. Suppose we want to insert one element, that is 10 here. After that, inserting 10, suppose we want to again insert second one, that is 20. While deleting the element, we want to delete first 20, after that 10, because the concept of last in, first out. First, we can delete 20 and after that next one is your 10. So, this is the concept of stack. Now, next one, stack, after stack there is a linear list data structure, that is your queue. Now, what is the difference between stack and queue? Stack is a last in, first out, but your queue is first in, first out, just reverse of your stack. The concept of queue, in queue, suppose this is your queue, in that initially our pointers for front and rear at the initial position, that is your minus 1, because array usually starts from the index 0. That's why initially front and rear at the position of minus 1. Suppose one element we want to insert into queue, that is your 10. Suppose we insert the element 10, then our rear pointer incremented to one position, that means rear incremented over here, and the rear position is 0 now. Again we want to insert another element, suppose 20, in that condition the rear position is incremented and pointed to the next position. This is the concept of your queue. Now, while deleting element from the queue, we want to delete it from the pointer front. This is your front pointer. Suppose we want to delete one element from this one, in that condition 10 is deleted from the queue first, that is first in, first out. That means front is initially, now here the first front is pointed here, then after deletion the front is going to decrement. This is all about the stack and queue, that is your linear list. Now next one is the non-linear list. That is comprises of two, that is tree and your graph. Now tree and graph, what is the difference between tree and graph? Now tree, concept of tree is while we want to store the data in hierarchical way, in that condition we want to store that data in a tree form. Take an example for the tree. Now take an example of tree. Tree is a hierarchical relationship shows for the data. Now take an example for tree. Suppose first data is A, B, E, F, G suppose. As per the hierarchy of tree, always the top hierarchy node is considered as the root node of the tree. And here D, E, F and G, these nodes are called as leaf nodes, because leaf nodes, they don't have any child, that's why they called as leaf node. This is the concept of tree. Now next, non-linear data structure is our graph. Basically, the graph is used for the different type of physical structure storage purpose, even in either in computer science or in geographical field also there is a use of graph. Take an example for the graph. Suppose there is a node that is A that connected to the next node that is B. Here is the node C that is connected with the node A. Next one, that is node D, that is connected with the node B and node C also, and node A also connected to the node D also. Here is the directions from A to B, from A to D and from A to C, C to D and from D to B. This is the example for the graph. Graph is a collection of vertices. Graph is a collection of vertices and the edges. Here are the A, B, C and D. These are the vertices and here edges are connected to all the vertices here. Like A, B, this is the edge for connecting the vertices A and B. So, this is the concept of our nonlinear list data structure, that is our graph. This is all about the classification of the data structure. Now, start with the next concept, that is our algorithm. Now, what is meant by the algorithm? Algorithm gives the set of finite set of instructions, or either we can say the logic to design the program. Let us take an example for the algorithm. Suppose we want to make an addition of two numbers. Suppose we want to add two numbers like A plus B and we want to store that result in third one, that is in C. For that we want to write an algorithm. In that condition we want to write stepwise procedure. Either we can say the instruction or a logic for implementing the addition. Now first step. For the first step of finding the addition, we want to take the two values for addition purpose, that is take input that is A and B. Here we take the input A and B. Let's say suppose value of A is 10 and value of B is 20. Now next step is for the algorithm is we want to add that value, that is we want to add that values, that is add A with B. This is the second step. Now whatever the result added with A with B, that result we want to store in third variable, that is in C. This is the third step. We want to store. We want to store the result of addition in third variable, that is in C. This is our third step. Now, after storing that value in C, we want to display the output on the screen. For that purpose, we want to display the value of C, and last step, that is our exit. Now this is the algorithm for adding the two numbers, that is A plus B, and result will be stored in the third component, that is in C. This is our algorithm. Now algorithm analyzed by the two factors, that is our time complexity and space complexity. Now we see the what is the difference between or the idea of the complexity. Analyze the algorithm analyzed by complexity. First one is our time complexity. And second one is our space complexity. Okay. Now, time complexity means what? For the execution of algorithm, we want the CPU required some time to execute the particular algorithm. That time required to completion, or we can say the execution of algorithm, is gives the time complexity. Just like that, space complexity is the space required to execute that algorithm. It gives our space complexity. Now, time complexity and space complexity is measured in three terms. First one is best case, second one is worst case, and third one is our average case. Now, what is best case, worst case, and the average case? Now, best case means the minimum time required to execute the algorithm. It gives the best case. Now, worst case means maximum time required to execute the algorithm. That gives the worst case time complexity. Average case time complexity means what? The average time required to execute the algorithm. It gives the average case complexity. In next lecture, we see the concept of array. In RTMNU syllabus, we all study the non-primitives data structure, like array, linked list, then next one is the tree, graph. In further lecture, we see the concept of array in detail. Thank you.